We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Excalibur Issue 1. This is from the 2019 series from Marvel Comics. The legacy number is not given on here. I think they forgot they used to have an Excalibur series. This is written by Tini Howard, art by Marcus Toe, Erick Arciniega, color artist, VC's Corey Pettit, letterer Tom Muller designs, cover art by Mahmud Asrar and Matthew Wilson. Jonathan Hickman is head of X, whatever that means. Annalise Bissa is assistant editor, Jordan D. White editor. Alright, so something is going on in Otherworld, which is the realm of King Arthur, which is where Brian Braddock draws his powers to become Captain Britain, and it looks like a Krakoa gate has appeared in the pool of Morgan Le Fay, and she's not happy about that obvious invasive invasion of her area, which, you know, I guess the X-Men just don't care. They think everything belongs to them, and they have a right to go wherever they want, and just wander into people's castles. And we find out Jamie Braddock is back to being alive. Psylocke ventures out to the island to kind of see what's going on there, and Brian gets summoned back to Otherworld to help out. Morgan Le Fay calls these people Witchbreed, which is her way of saying mutants, and there's an interesting showdown at the end of the book. We get some other characters involved. We got Rogue and Gambit and Jubilee. Some of the dialogue is really obnoxious. There's an interesting twist, which is probably just another replacement theory nonsense and probably going to be permanent because Marvel Comics hates legacy characters because, you know, certain genders and skin tones aren't welcome there. But the cover is cool. Too pink, though. I seriously think there must have been a really good sale on pinks and purples because there's a lot of them in this book and it's really obnoxious. Some of the art is very inconsistent. There's times when it looks really, really good, and there's times like when they're at the Braddock estate where it looks like the backgrounds are traced. Looks like they were cutting some corners maybe to make the time frame. There's 8 of those stupid white pages in here. That's where your extra dollar went. This $5 book would have been $4 if they could have trimmed that garbage out, because it's really just filler. It's flavor text almost entirely. The rest could have been inserted in captions. Fight scene at the end is pretty good. It makes sense, and there's some stuff with cults. Overall, it's an okay book. I was actually impressed. I usually don't like Tini Howard's writing. Some of the dialogue is garbage and didn't need to be in here. They could have toned a lot of that down. Aside from that, the general plot was pretty decent. It's a good start. I wouldn't mind reading issue 2 if somebody gave it to me for free or it got it for a dollar. This is not worth $5. It's an okay issue, but the mutants obviously think they are entitled to go wherever they want, whenever they want, and no one's gonna stop them. And I don't think anybody is gonna stop them, because supervillainy and ego are the way of the future for Marvel Comics. X-Men, anyway. Overall, I would say this is worth reading. I don't think it was too bad. Was it worth the $5? No. But it's worth checking out if you could find it for about $2.50 or maybe $3. Beyond that, I don't think it was worth anywhere near $5, especially with all those white pages and a lot of fluffy dialogue in there to kind of fill things up. So that being said, I would say it's middle of the road, mediocre issue. It's not the worst of them so far. Marauders was probably my least favorite of them, but I thought this was actually better than X-Men issue 1. So that being said, I'll give this a recommendation only if you can find it for $3 or less. But that's just my opinion. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.